This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The King's Cross Railway accident occurred on 4 February 1945, at London King's Cross Railway Station on the East Coast Main Line of the London. The number 1 down main line could be reached from platforms 5, 6 or 7, when points 145 were normal. This line was reached from platforms 8 to 17. The signal box controlling this was situated at the end of platforms 5. The rearmost coach was a vestibuled brake composite, No. 1889, which had been built at Doncaster in 1941 as part of an order for 10 authorized in 1939 against order No. 999. The design, known as Diagram 314, used a steel underframe 60 feet 18. To grip the rail and eventually came to a stand preoccupied with his tasks at the controls and operating in darkness. The driver didn't notice when the train slowed to a stop, and then began to run backwards. Meanwhile, the points behind the train number 145 had been set for the next departure, which was to be from platform 10. The coaches for this service, the 1900 Aberdonian to Aberdeen, were already in the platform. The signalman became aware of the 1800 train rolling back and operated the points again in order to route it into unoccupied platform 15, but he was too late. The first bogey of the rear coach BCK No. 1889 had already passed. This caused the two bogies to take different tracks. The rear of the train collided with the front of the coaches in platform 10. The rear coach rose into the air and struck a signal gantry, crushing one of the two first class compartments in the middle of the coach. Two passengers were killed, one of whom was Cecil Kimber, a former controller of the MG Car Company. After the accident, the signal gantry demolished in the collision carried shunting discs and platform indicators in addition to main aspect signals in an emergency measure. Hand signalers were introduced to control main line trains using platforms 6 to 17, as well as movements to and from the locomotive yard. Suburban services were terminated and turned round at Finsbury Park. Coach No. 1889 was so severely damaged that it was written off. It had been scheduled to be renumbered 10,153, but that number then remained unused. 2 weeks later, the signal gantry was replaced, but complete services were not restored until 23 February 1945. The accident has variously been described as somewhat bizarre and stupid. The inspecting officer, Colonel Wilson, concluded in his report that the main fault lay with the driver. Although it was difficult for him to tell which direction he was moving in the tunnel, he should have anticipated the possibility that he might roll back after the prolonged slipping. He did not realize for some minutes after the train had stopped that a collision had occurred. A similar accident occurred at Glasgow Queen Street in 1928, involving a lighter train but on a much steeper gradient. Notes carat the present day platforms 4, 5. Carrot Wilson 1945, p. References. Body, M. G., Neve, E., Yedin, W. B. April 1973. Fry, E. V., Ed. Part 2A, Tender Engines, Classes A1 to A10 Locomotives of the LNER Kenilworth, RCTS. ISBN. E. Rail Accidents in London. Harrow 1838, Lewisham 1857, Kentish Town 1861, Norwood Junction 1891, Ilford 1915, Battersea Park 1937, Ilford 1944, King's Cross 1945, South Croydon 1947, Harrow and Wealdstone 1952, Stratford 1953, Barnes 1955, Lewisham 1957, Dagenham East 1958, Hither Green 1967, Eltham Well Hall 1972. Ealing 1973, Moorgate 1975, Holborn 1980, Wembley Central 1984, Clapham Junction 1988, Purley 1989, Cannon Street 1991, Southall 1997, Ladbroke Grove 1999, Spa Road 1999, Croydon 2016. Rail accidents in the United Kingdom. VE Railway accidents in 1945. London, United Kingdom 4.